Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. Artcast number 408, I believe. Or it could be 409, but I'm pretty sure it's 408. I wanted to talk a little bit about storyboarding and thumbnailing, as far as like animation goes, and also thumbnailing my comic. So let me show you guys.
This is actually one, basically, I call them like thumbnails if they're for my comic, and then storyboards if they're for the animation. But basically, this is one of my thumbnails for page 19 of my comic. Here's page 18, 17. You guys get the point. There's 16, 15. So I do them on index cards, as you guys can see. I just do them real rough. I do them in blue pencil and Sharpie marker. And they're good enough I can tell what's going on, or somebody can look at them and tell what's going on. So like in this panel, you got the Berserker Knot and the girl. They're looking up at this giant statue, and there's like a giant crack going up the top. And then there's like a little shot of their reaction of that right there in the corner. And how I do these is I start with these kinds of things here. These are actually the sketches of that panel I just showed you right here. So this would be one statue, that would be the other. There's that. And then this is that insert panel. But if you go on to the next one, hopefully you guys can see that. These are really rough. And even like when I look at it, it's kind of hard. What's going on here is the statue's kind of coming down, and then that's a shot of them almost getting smashed, and then there's like a big boom shot. And then this goes on to the next page. This would be like page 17. Then I just redraw it on this page in blue line, Sharpie in the details. And so like the statue comes down, they're kind of ducking, and then there's a big boom. That's kind of like a spoiler for anybody who's reading the comic right now. But I just do tons of these. Here's like another one. And they're just normal copy paper. And I just scribble out the book like at high speed. And I don't really worry about paneling at this point. I just do a drawing, do the next drawing, do the next drawing, do the next drawing. And I'm kind of writing as I go. I have a Word document open on my computer, and I just list the panels like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then I do a short description or a little bit of dialogue in each line as I kind of roll down them. So like on 11, there's some just some dialogue that's happening. Like 12, then there's just a, it says breaks TV. 13, then there's some more dialogue. 14, and then it just kind of goes through the panels, with each one. So now let me show you guys something else. These are my storyboards, and this is the way I do them. Same thing with like a note card. And I just draw, one frame on each card. And the reason I like to do this is then if I mess up, if I go off on some crazy direction, what does it really cost me? It costs me like 15 minutes of drawing on note cards. I just throw those out and I put new ones in. If I miss a scene or I need to bulk out a scene, it's an easy thing to just draw some more note cards and just stick them in there. And then eventually, this is what I do with them. I just tape them down into pages. As you can see, then you come down here, right there, there. It goes up there, boom, boom, boom. Then I need to tape some more in, but you guys get the idea. It's all lined up like a giant kind of comic book that explains the story. The difference between like the storyboards for the animation and then the thumbnails for the comic book pages is that with the storyboards for the animation, I put it together so that I can follow it and make an animation out of it. So like the storytelling in the comics is way more compressed, whereas like with the storyboards, I'm trying to make sure that I have a drawing of like every shot, and then I have drawings of a lot of the action in each shot. So if you were just sitting there and reading it, it wouldn't be as fun an experience as like a comic book, because a comic book is way more compressed, in the art. You don't show like every action, every reaction. A lot of that's just filled in kind of by the reader, in between the panels. But with like a storyboard, you want all of the pertinent stuff because you're gonna, you know, eventually build everything that you have in there and then also shoot everything that you have.
As you guys can see, I had all the, you know, storyboard drawings that I've been drawing for the next animation, and I haven't talked a ton about that, just because, you know, I'm just waiting until it kind of gets going like more full throttle, and then I will start talking about it. Then I'll start showing you what I'm doing and everything. But I have a short animation that I planned out to basically happen this year and end at the end of the year, or get close to being done around the end of the year. So we'll see how that all works. And you know, once I start doing that, I'll start making like the Friday animation videos again and all that. But you know, it's funny. It's like my storyboards and my sketching process has become like more tight over time. And I think a lot of that has come from the animation, because it's like, if I have any sort of help on the animation, it's hard to sort of tell someone, you know, whether it's like my wife or whoever, you know, tell someone else how to do stuff. You know what I mean? It's like, you can explain it to them forever and they still might not get it. But once you draw it into like a little picture, then it's like the light bulb goes off and they immediately get it. It's like all right there. And so I've kind of come around, you know, like a lot of times, you know, in the past I would just like those blue, like the light blue kind of scribbly sketches I was showing you guys. It's like, that would be my thumbnails and I would just sketch that out and then I would just go on from that. But what I've found is by kind of going back and just tightening up each one, and I'm not saying, you know, go back and like, you know, spend a day on it or whatever. Like when I tighten those up to like kind of that Sharpie marker kind of look, that literally like takes me, I'd say maybe 10 minutes for each one. And so, you know, like in the space of a couple hours, I can get like 20 done. And that is a little extra time, but I feel like it's so worth it. And then I also really like the fact that you can like literally, you know, you can see the finished product then. And when you get on those days, like when you wake up and you're kind of like, okay, I got to get onto the next page or whatever. And, you sort of like don't quite know where things are going and sort of like, and that can, you know, kind of stop you. Maybe you don't start drawing immediately because you're sort of just like in that daze of like, well, you know, what's going to happen next kind of thing, you know? And you know, that all that kind of stuff just kind of slows you down. But then, you know, if you have that, like the thumbnails laid out, like that roadmap laid out, it's just so much, I find it just so much easier to just keep pumping away. And I think that's why I'm doing better on this comic than I've ever really done on, you know, any kind of web comic type thing that I started before, as far as, you know, just chugging along. And also, you know, just with the animation, it's, you know, it's kind of nice, you know, like with my last project, I planned it, you know, it was so big, you know what I mean? It's just kind of like this ongoing thing that never ends. So it was hard to sort of plan out how many sets you need, how many armatures you need, just all the sort of like materials of like what you're going to need. Not that you need all that stuff in the beginning. You know, you only need what you're going to shoot at the time, but it's helpful, you know, I mean, just like the armatures, you know, like now that I'm planning out this next one, you know, it's like, I know that I need like 7 armatures and I can build all those armatures in 1 month, like at the same time. And that's going to just save me having to kind of go back into that state of building armatures like over and over and over again. And that's just going to save me like a lot of time. So that's kind of my, you know, storyboarding thumbnail process, you know, in a nutshell. I start with those sketches like early on, you know, like I actually start sketching out scenes and stuff before I finish writing. I kind of start out with like the outline, and before that there's kind of, it's just me, you know, just walking around thinking. And I really don't even start outlining till I kind of have a plot or whatever, like an idea in my head. And then once I kind of have that idea, then I just start writing. And I never really write the full scripts. Then I go into those like, you know, really loose sketches, and I just sketch and sketch and sketch all the way to the end, and I don't stop anywhere along there. I, for some reason, that's important. Like when I break that flow, it's really hard to get back into that. So a lot of times when I get into those, like that sketching thing, I'll just, you know, I'll go through like 20 pieces of paper just as fast as I can and just get it all down. And a lot of times when I go back and I look through it, sometimes it'll be kind of hard for me to even tell what's going on because I'll be drawing like so quickly. you know, that's not necessarily a bad thing because it's almost like another pass. So like once you start, once I start taking that stuff, putting it onto the note cards and tightening it up, it's like it shows me sort of the problems that I didn't see on the first pass when I was going like so fast. And like smart makes me start thinking about like, well, you know, if you set up this, you know, the camera angles like this, then it would be, you know, a little different. And then, you know, it's like, it's funny. It like builds on itself. You know, it's like when I get to the comic book page, a lot of times when I'm looking at that thumbnail and I'm looking at that page, I'll start thinking, well, you know, it'd work better if like, you know, this angle was turned around and, you know, you're shooting like over this guy's shoulder or whatever. And the same thing with the animation, I noticed like in my last animation, you know, especially when the guard was like walking down the hallway and he jumped and all that, I had all that storyboarded out, but it completely changed in the editing, you know? So that was even after I'd shot, I just like, was like, when I put the shot, the pieces of the shots together in the actual movie, I realized that, you know, flipping a couple of those shots, putting them in different orders, like works so much better than the way I had, you know, envisioned it in the first place. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Check out Patreon if you want to support the videos, and I'll see you next time.